Now we are on to speaking part of test 1. We have certain parts, part 1, part 2, part 3. In part 1, the examiner is going to ask you about yourself, your home, work and studies, and other familiar topics. So you need to be ready and prepare yourself that this question is going to come for sure. Then he or she is going to ask certain questions. Like this, we are going to take one by one. And the part two, let us answer for part one, then we'll go to part two. So the examiner, when he or she asks you for yourself, your home, work or studies, you can answer that I am so and so. I work here or there. And I'm basically from this place, say I'm basically from Delhi, and I work in Dehradun for this software consultancy. Or if you're studying, you can say that I'm basically from Agra and I'm studying my engineering at Warangal. I love watching cricket and watching television, especially sports and news. Then you may be asked these few questions. For example, what games are popular in your country and why? Then the answer would be, in my country, because I am an Indian, in my country, cricket is the most popular game, followed by hockey and football. And why cricket is popular is because everyone plays it, everyone loves watching it, may it be a kid or an elder person or elderly person, all age ranges, they love to watch it because cricket gives you pleasure. Cricket is a game which is very undecided, and Indian players especially, they are doing well, they do well, and we have greatest of player to name a few. That's why cricket is popular, and because hockey is our national game, so this hockey is also being played very much in India. Then the second question, it may be, do you play any games? Why or why not? Then you can just say that, yes, I play badminton or cricket, any game you can say. I play badminton because it is an indoor game, only two people are required. And since the place where I work, I have a very good court where we have very good players and facilities, and it's very easy to reach there, and because all exercises which I need is fulfilled by this game. That is why I love playing badminton. Then you, in this question, how do people learn to play games in your country? In this, you can start by saying that mostly we learn playing games in our school. In our school, we have a special session or period for games. And once we start playing, then our teacher, if we are good at playing, then the teacher may watch us. And if we are good, then he may pick up for the later means inter-school games, and once we are there, then we can also be chosen for the regional team, and this is how the progress goes. One more thing is that if you are good and if your parents are they are also players and they want you to pursue a particular game and you are good at them, then we have regional or state facilities, we can go to the stadium, we get very good coaches, and then we can start the play and learn from them. Then the question would be, do you think it's important for people to play games? Why or why not? Then you can answer like this, that indeed, playing games solves two purposes. First, it relieves you from all the stress and strain which you had, or you know, normal life, social life, any problem you have, it can be relieved. And the most important aspect is you and your body remains fit. You know, you always require an exercise for say 45 to 1 hour, and you need to give this time to your body. And if you're playing such game, then your body, your mind, they remain fit. So this is what you can answer. Then the part two is like this: describe an open air or street market which you enjoyed visiting. You will have to talk about this topic for 1 or 2 minutes, and you have 1 minute to think about what you're going to say. You can make some notes to help if you wish. So you can do that. You can write and speak. So let me give you an example that the way you can say, because where is the market, what the market sells, how big is the market, and explain why you enjoy visiting the market. So you can answer like this. We have an open street market in Dehradun, which is called as Indira Market. The most important aspect of this market is they sell, and the shops located there is they sell all gadgets, clothes, and most of the thing which people would require. The market is not very big, but still it suffices, or it completes all your requirement. I enjoy visiting that market because it is centrally placed. It is near our central business district, which is known as Clock Tower, and it is nearly accessible. You have a parking place, and moreover, you get things and clothes and various electronic gadgets in a very cheap and negotiable price. So this way you can answer this type of questions. Then you have part three, which comes under discussion topics, and like shopping at markets. For example, you have some questions like this: do people in your country enjoy going to open markets, open air market that sell things like food or clothes or cold objects? Which type of market is more popular and why? You can answer like this, that in my country lately, various joints, various multi-storied, you can say that, you know, malls are coming up, but still people enjoy going to open air markets because they sell good food, they provide all the facilities and things and stuff which we would require, and moreover, they are cheap as well as acceptable. Then you have, do you think markets are more suitable places for selling certain type of things? Which ones? What do you think this is? So if your examiner asks you that, do you think markets are more suitable places for selling certain type of things? Which ones? What do you think this? So you can answer like this. If a market has all your requirement, the market can complete all your requirement or fulfill all your requirement, then I would prefer to go to that market, because just going to a place where I get one stuff or another market which fulfills my certain requirement, I would prefer that I go to a market where things are available of each and every type, and that too which is suitable for my requirement, which completes my requirement. Then do you think young people feel the same about shopping at market as older people? Why is that? You know, you can answer in your scenario that being an Indian, in our scenario, younger people, they would like and they prefer to go to the malls. Means multi-storied food joints and selling markets, because they want some entertainment, some food, along with some purchasing. While older people, they are interested more in buying and finding various options and also saving money. So this is what older people, they prefer to do while shopping. Then comes shopping in general. There are certain example questions. What do you think are the advantages of buying things from shops rather than markets? What do you think are advantages of buying things from shops rather than markets? In this you can answer, well, the first advantage of buying things from shops rather than market is that shop, it provides you different options, various options, along with the quality. Price and quality both are our utmost priority, and that shops fulfill. While going to a market, you may find certain things very good at first sight, but may not be so quality wise may not be so good. That is why we need to go to the shops rather than markets. Then how does advertising influence what people choose to buy? Is this true for everyone? Then you can answer like this. In my opinion, advertising, it does influence people when they choose to buy, because the thing which they hear either from radio or from television or from some other marketing material, they always get biased, because they know that the company which is selling the product, they are serious about their sell, and they also provide, you know, in advertisement they provide ISI mark or this quality certified or this is good for this. So we get biased if we find any other object that may be good, but may not be well known. We would prefer to buy something which we know by advertising. And this is, I guess, this is true for everyone, because everyone is related or being influenced by some or the other marketing or advertising media. Then, do you think that any recent changes in the way people live have affected general shopping habits? Why is this? Yes, in my opinion, recent changes, because I live in a developing country, so we have various malls and different multi-story markets which are coming up. So people, they tend to buy in these joints now rather than going to the traditional markets. They would not prefer. Only the people who are having a moderate income or low income, they, or who could not afford, they go to the market which are traditionally established and selling cheap goods or stuff that they would require. So this is how you answer. I may not be very good, but still I have given you an idea, and you can make it more sophisticated. You can use your own vocabulary and make it more clean, smooth and understandable. Thank you so much. Take care.